Ouais.
Your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, trying to fly away. No, doing stuff and things on the Ark Survival Evolved, Pooping Evolved server. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really great day. We got all sorts of new stuff and things going on around here, and I'm really excited to hang out with you guys today. Want to take a second to tell you guys, thank you so much for all your well wishes. Let me go like this. Thank you so much for all your well wishes. I'm bowing my head for the sad passing of Foul Play. Which really was a loss of a dino that kind of bugged me. It was my first perfect tame. I was really hoping to help him, to keep him around and have fun with him. But like so many, he left us too early and too young. But we have a lot of other cool dinos, and we're going to get another one. I've got a couple of stegos over here that I did some taming off camera. I'm going to tell you guys about it in a little bit. I wanted to make sure, I can't remember if I told you guys about this, that we got this Dodicarus that DMAC actually dropped off for us. So I was looking for a high one. I wanted something at least over 80. This guy was 88. DMAC brought him over on a Quetzal and dropped him off right in the base area. So we just tamed him up. And we got to get a name for him. So he's a blue stone gathering dino. Pretty sharp looking. I got to tell you right there. He's pretty got a pretty sharp saddle. Looks pretty great. So if you guys have a suggestion for a name, make sure you put it in the comment section of the down there. And, another thing also, as far as the well wishes and stuff on the last couple of videos, I do appreciate that stuff so much. But also, in the Perfect Tame video, I think we're up to almost 15,000 likes on it. Thank you guys so much for showing your support and hitting the like button. I really, really appreciate it. If you guys like this video, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more ARK stuff and things. So I want to get a little bit more organized with the dinos. I feel like everything's kind of willy-nilly in and about the area. I'm a little wary to start building yet because I just want to get a really big supply of metal, everything, ready to rock and roll. So over here you can see we've got, where is it? No, get back in there. 62 metal pillars and 34 ceilings right now. So we've got to start for sure, but I mean, I'm thinking we're going to need, I mean, like a couple hundred ceilings, a lot of stuff. So we're going to continue to work on that as well. As far as the stegos go, so I'm kind of feeling bummed about losing the perfect tame. So I decided what we're going to do is retribution. We're going to rise. We're not going to let it bother us. We're going to rise up and we're going to conquer it. We're going to conquer this and get another one. And so I decided that what we're going to do is keep some stegos right over here in the area. Now I've got 6 stegos here, 1 male and 5 females. And we've already got a couple of stego eggs over in the area here. That's going to allow us to make stego kibble. Obviously, what it is, the kibble that RGs like the best. So I built another preserving bin over here. And we've got 2 already stego kibble. And I just got those. I also went out and got a bunch of meat cooked up and put it in the industrial grill up on slow mobility. And so we did that too. What else behind the scenes stuff have I done so you guys can know kind of the stuff and things? Oh, I've been doing a little bit more gathering of some supplies. I was running a little bit low on cementing paste, so I went out and did another run and got some more chitin. I think there's some more cementing paste right there. So we could squirt that inside of here. Let's take out 2 of these guys. And on the dough dick, I'd gone out and got a bunch of metal as well. So, or pardon me, stone, I said. And so we still have a bit of that here. 1, 2... Let's go 5, 10. No, wait, I dropped. There we go. 90, 90. Like so. And so I've been making up a little bit more cementing paste so we can get that big stockpile of stuff and things going so we can build kind of a lot at once. Like, I don't think we'll build the entire base like in one sitting just because I want it to be a little bit bigger and really cool. But I don't want to have to stop in the middle of base building and like go gather resources for hours and then come back. Like, I want to be able to just kind of go with it. So over here, let's take a look at our Toto list again. Make sure we're on point here. Dodic for stone. Nail the ace that can't be stopped. Crosses something off the Toto list. Progression, that's what we're all about. 2, RG sad face. Still need that. 3, a Quetzal because they're BA. Yep. Base building supplies, we just talked about. Elevators, very interesting. Something we might play around with very, very soon. And 5, of course, put vanilla pudding and manager in public. Pretty important. And on the list, not sure if that's going to work out. I don't know. The ARK devs, they're not really, I don't know if they're really going to put that in the game, but I feel like probably not. But yeah, so a couple of things also happened. There was a sign over there. I actually took it down. But there's a new business. I'm going to grab some berries off of Slow Mobility to put inside of the preserving or the feeding trough over here. But there's a new business in Poop City called Dino Co., which is something for all your gassy needs. And I guess they're selling gas there. Now, also, after I saw the sign, Drax got in touch with me. Wait, why? Fight! Who's fighting? I need an RG. Where are you, stupid big pigeon? The fight's over already suddenly. Why is the fight over already suddenly? I feel like that's not the case. Where's the fight? Oh, you know what? I bet something's on the other side of the wall here. What? Normally this has been happening where I get this fight music. Oh, there it is right there. So these guys are like Attack of the Base or something. They're seeing through there somehow. All right. Do they actually damage the dinos? Oh, yeah. He moved. Do you have any damage taken? No. Do you have any damage taken? No. Okay. They're not actually hitting it, doesn't look like. She moved. Pardon me. So before we were so rudely interrupted by the raptors, there's a new business in Poop City. Like I was saying, Dino Co. It's for all your gassy needs. I'm assuming that they're selling gas. We're going to have to take a trip over and take a look at that. But also, Drax contacted me today, and he had about 1,800 gas that he wanted to get rid of, and he wanted to sell it to me for metal. So where's the double? There he is right there. So I decided to sell him 1,800 gas and in exchange give him 1,000 metal. So for me, metal is not terribly hard to come by. It's more the time it takes to go ahead and farm it. But inside of here, you can see we've still got 1, 2, 3. We had like over 6,000 metal. We've got 3,000 in here. Anything in there yet? Anymore? No. And then here's all of our gas now. Huge amount of gasoline. We're not going to need any for a really long time. But I did think it was a little bit odd that... Oh, is there a preserving bin over here? Oh, there's jerky crapple in here and I forgot about it. Crap. Oh, let me grab this stuff. Crap. I totally forgot I had that preserving bin there. We'll go put it in the other one if we have room. But I thought it was weird that Zul'jin and Drax going into business together, which is what I think that Dino Co. is, and then having kind of Drax come back around and sell me, you know, individual gas for metal. So I'm not sure exactly what was going on there. But, all right, that being said, we are going to now head over to Poop City and take a look at the new business. And also, there's a house that I forgot to show you guys about in the world tour. We're going to talk about that, too. Oh, BRBs, peeps. And we're back. What's this over here? This is a 109 named Buck. I'm going to guess this is Miola. Just lying on the ground here, passed out. Man, Miola's got some problems. He just passed out wherever he just sits. This guy's cute, man. Level 109 needs a saddle, though. But over here is Dino Co. Let's take a look at it. It looks pretty cool, man. Check it out. Like, they got the Dino Co. emblem up there. Oiled and hide to fuel your ride. I think it's oil and hide. Our gas has pizzazz. Look at all these slogans. Only a fool wouldn't buy our fuel. What's this one over here? Fuel your oven with Dino Co. lovin'. Man, they just try to get all the advertising dollars they can get. 100 high quality Dino Co. gasoline equals 200 spark powder. Okay, so they got some Dino Co. gasoline over there. Payment goes here. Oh, no one's bought anything yet. And it looks like this is like, oh, I see what they've done. So this is like their little stand where they can stand here and sell you stuff and have a little combo. What do you got in here? Nothing. Well, just looking all, you got to look in all the chests and see what all the stuff and things are. Let's pop out of there. What's on top of this building? Let's see. This is the Dino Co. sign. That's pretty cool, man. I like that a lot. It's got like an elephant. Like that's their symbol, a pink elephant. I don't know why it's a pink elephant. but Dino Co. fuel, pink elephant. It's like powerful, like an elephant's powerful, I think. So, if we ever need any fuel, which we don't, cause we have 1800 from Drax selling it to us for 1,000 metal. Yeah, we'll come here. So it's a good business. Anybody else on the server can check it out. It's pretty cool. What else has gone on? We haven't been to Poop City. Well, we did the world tour the other day, so we came over to see that. And while we were over here for that, I didn't show you guys Monkey Farm's base right here. Look at this thing, man. You know what? He did a really cool thing I want to show you guys, too. So let's take a look at it really quickly. He's got a big, big, ginormous Quetzal as well. Level 121, the Fonz. Hey, what's this say? Monkey Farm's beach hut. All right. So let's pop around the front here. This is a really cool thing that he's done. You know what? I neglected to show this off, and I really should have, because this looks great, man. I like these ladders in front of the windows, like bars almost. And he's got benches down below. And you can use it to climb up. He's got a whole bunch of stuff and things going on here. Did he build... Wait, what? Oh, we can't get up there because there's a guy. Did he use the stone... Oh, look at that. Stone Dino Gate as his back door here. Oh, yeah. So this is his little ramp, it looks like, for exterior access to all of his stuff and things. That's a really good idea. Let's pop open this bad boy, see what we got inside. Dodgeball, 165 Dodic, some nice little water. I like those windows a lot. That's a really cool idea. He's got a lot of hot window action up in this piece. And he's got... Well, this guy's kind of wacky. What's your name, homie? Mr. Toad, what color is your tongue? Oh, wait. We got to look up a little bit more. Just red? Well, okay, you know, not everyone can have a white tongue like Bayou. That guy looks smart. Are you super smart? Woolly Harrelson. Woolly Harrelson. Looks like he's got a second floor. Let's pop up here real quick. There he is right there. He's just sleeping. Yeah, so pretty cool base design, guys, and some cool aesthetics that I missed when we did the world tour. So I wanted to come over and show you guys real fast. All right, so that's all some cool stuff and things. Poop City, looking pretty good. Let's pop over here. All right, so now we saw the Dinoco in the new building. We saw Monkey Farm's really cool build. I think we are going to start to get some building done over at the main base. It's just time. I'm thinking that we're going to play around with maybe some elevators or something like that. At least get some sort of something done. Because, like I was saying, I just feel, or actually, I don't think I said this, but I had it in my brain place. I feel like unorganized over there. Like, you know, we've been living there now for a long time and we just don't have anything going. So it's time, peeps. We got to get something going. So I'm going to get probably the dinos organized and kind of get a basic plan for some sort of starting spot. Get some stuff and things done. And then I'll BRB's, peeps. And we're back up at the Mountain Forge doing stuff and things. We're actually killing, a couple scorpions right now and getting some obsidian. So I was taking a look at what I kind of wanted to get done next. Like, I really want to do this metal building stuff and I really want it to be kind of amazing, right? One of the things that's turning out, like I was taking a look at the recipes, especially for the elevators, and this stuff is super expensive, guys, like crazy. And one of the things we really need to get a lot of is we need polymer and electronics. So polymer and electronics are mostly powered by, or what we need that we don't have for both of those is obsidian, and we need silica pearls as well. So there's a few things that I've been getting together here. So back at Poop City, I actually forgot about this. I had a set of scuba gear. So I went and got my scuba gear from Poop City. I got this fur armor. Actually, Drax gave this to me because we lost it when we lost Foul Play. Came back up here. And earlier today, I think I had said I was doing some resource gathering. These guys are actually still firing up. And so I grabbed a bunch of the metal as well. So you can see Tonnage right here has 600 metal on him. And then Poundage over here, I think, has 4. And then what I wanted to do as well was get a bunch of obsidian. I thought I had some already ready to rock, but I don't. So we're out on ingot right now. I'm just going to drop some of this stuff we don't need. Flowers will take. This will take. All right. But anywho, so the point being that we're over here now. We're getting some stuff and things. We're doing the gathering stuff, and we're getting it all done. So, but what I wanted to do was come up here and do this. But I think the adventure that we're going to go on today is going to be to go and get... Oh, I got extra metal. We put extra metal in here. The adventure that we're going to go on today is going to be going to get some silica pearls. So it's going to be pretty awesome. We're going to head out, and I'm a little bit afraid. I'm not sure. I think the best place to go is going to be the northern area over there. And kind of along the coast there, I know there's some silica pearls. We might go try to get one of the ichthys that we have and head out into the water, too. That's what the scuba gear's for. Got a little bit more obsidian here. But I thought we'd start off, I'd just let you guys know, gathering up some obsidian stuff and things. What's his weight at now? 5? So we could probably get a little bit more. Grabbing this, and then I will meet you guys back once I've delivered this back to the base. I'll meet you guys over at the northern area, and we're going to do some silica pearl hunting, peeps. I will be our bees. And we're back on the hunt for silica pearls. And I'm not sure if everybody knows this, but over in the northern area here, there have been some changes to where you can get some resource stuff and things. Is that something right on the ground? No, that's the white ferns. So I was just taking a look. I can't remember if there's any. Yeah, there's some right in here as well. So, so right in the northern area, like right off the coast in a couple of spots, now you can just get silica pearls like right away. Actually, you can see right here. Let's just land for a second and see if there's any wolves in the area. Okay, there's none for now. And then let's set you onto passive. So you can just go right out, right in the water, very, very close over here. And there's a whole batch of them, like right here. Look at this. We're going to get probably maybe like 100 or something like that. And, oh crap, I don't have my scuba gear on right now. Probably would have been a good idea to grab some just so that I can swim a little faster. But can I not harvest you, homie? All right, there we go. There's that guy and there's this guy. And I'll show you on the map where we are really quick. I think that's probably going to be it. We'll just head toward the shore so we can get there a little bit quicker. But yeah, we're right on the northwestern edge of the stuff and things. So you can see where we are on the map right there. Me in the top corner. So like 22 latitude, 40 longitude. And we've already picked up 131. So straight away, like you can get these. They're right out in the area, right kind of all over this place. There's some right there too. You know, I'm wondering, can I just take off? Let me see here. We'll put this stuff all on me. And then can I just take off my boots and get the benefit of the fast swimming from the fins? Oh, yeah, you can, baby. Oh, nailed it, because we don't really need to be worried about like the air and stuff like that right here. So this is like a really nice spot. It's really easy to get to, fairly safe, and you can get a whole batch of pearls here. Now, your fins, of course, are going to make it so you can't walk very fast. So you got to be careful about that. So we're going to take off. It's turning night. But look, there's even more, man. This is crazy. We already got how many? 200. Like, this has made it, like, really nice and much easier to gather. Now, it's still really... Were we just ice cube on land, but then frost in the water? That was weird. There's, like, a little spot. So, anywho, so what I was saying is this has made it kind of easier to get the pearls. You still are in a dangerous spot, so you got to be careful. But at the very least, you know what I mean? You don't need like a special diner or anything to get these. And look at them all, man. Oh, it's really cool. At night right now, I can see like where all of them are. That's so cool, man. All right, it looks like there's some up in the river here as well. Oh, baby, we're going to be silica pearl rich. I'm going to grab some more of these guys. If I find another spot that's cool, I'll show that off to you too. I like doing this at night. It's kind of cool. I know it's just super dark for you, but anyway. All right, I'm going to grab some more guys, these guys, and then I'll be our bees, peeps. Ah, wolf attack! No, don't kill me, wolf! No, no! Wait, what? What? You're like the scariest wolf ever. You know, I wish I could bring you home to my base like a Halloween costume. Like a Halloween, like put you in front of my front door like a scary wolf. What are you doing, wolf? You silly wolf. You want to get punched? You want to get knocked out? Oh. Whatever, wolf. I need silica pearls. I can't be bothered. You know, guys, I just wanted to bring you back to show you this. I didn't really even realize. I was just heading up the coast. I knew they were here, but I didn't realize in what numbers, like the amount of pearls in this area. I just grabbed a huge amount. And then in these little inlets and all over the place, there's just a ton of them. So like right now, I'm just a little bit further down the shore. I mean, I haven't even gone that far. You can see right behind me where we were, where we got the first pearls there. And then check this out. We got another 100, another 100, another 100, put that, another 100 like so. We're only at weight 198. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We got 1,000. 1,000 silica pearls already. Is that another one right there? I think that is another silica pearl. We're going to head a little bit further up here. And at night, they're really easy to see. But pretty much in the daytime at any point, I mean, you can see where these guys are. So I'm just kind of taking a look up here all along the coastline. I think further down, there might be even more of these guys. And also, every time I come here to this biome, I am just blown away. It's kind of foggy out right now, but it's such a cool spot, man. It's just so neat. But yeah, I think down here, there's even more silica pearls. And I'd love to just get like a huge amount of them, I guess. I'm not sure how long it takes them to respawn. I think like 15 or 20 minutes at least. So we're just going to kind of do our thing here. But I'm just trying to see up in this area if there's any another spot that's got any. I think maybe up over here there might be. And we're back just up the coast a little bit more. As you can see, there's where we are on the map. Probably 18, 19 latitude and what is that? 18, 19 longitude. There's a little outcropping right here along the coast where there is, most of this is sheer cliff. But look at it again, guys, right here. Just this crazy, crazy amount of pearls everywhere. I actually don't even know if you need to get wet for these. Well, you do. But all along this area right here, now we're ice cubing. What are you, a flying shark? Why are you just flying out there, man? We're getting a little ice cubey, but check it out. I mean, again, just like a huge amount. So cool, man. I know, you're ice cubed. Let's see how many we can get. Oh, can you like get under here? Oh my God, is that cool? It's like floaty ice. So cool. I love you, northern biome. I would love to see these guys go back and redress some of the existing biomes that are kind of more plain now. All right, so we get another one up in here. Is there any more? Oh, look at this, man. More right here. There's another one there. There's oil to be had all down inside of there. Huge amounts. Let me eat a little bit. Oh, I can't eat. Sorry. There we go. Let's get a little bit of food in our bellies. Head down around here like a so. And even more? This is crazy. Give it to me, the pearls. And I think that's where it ends on this edge. Then these ice flows all start. We've got our scuba gear on. Let's take a little trip down here and see what's... It doesn't look like there's anything bad down here, but I'm just trying to see if there's even more pearls down underneath. And it looks like there's a little deposit here, nothing major. Two or three. But still, pretty crazy. We've already got another... 400-ish, something like that. Oh, swim, homie, swim. We're almost out of air. What are you doing? You gonna die? Don't die. Don't die. Swim, gator. Swim, gator! Oh, just barely made it. Don't drown, homie. All right, but yeah, so the dealio is... Is that a dead bird? What the crap happened? Stupid pigeon! Help! Oh, no! Big problem. Oh, big problem. Why are you? Why? Why? Why, cruel world? Why? Oh, he ate all my... Oh, he ate me up. And we're back. There's a stupid wolf. Come here, stupid pigeon. We're going to kill this guy. We got to find a safe spot to land, which would not be over there. Are you coming? Why are you so slow? All right. Safe spot to land. Is that a... Yep, it is. All right, we're losing HPs because we are super cold. Let's switch mounts real fast. Real fast, I said. All right, switch mounts. And then are you burdened or anything? No. Come here, double. And we will whistle passive. Let's come down here. Kill this stupid wolf that came out of nowhere. Where are you, dumb wolf? Yeah, look at you just gloating with your stupid wolfy grin over my body. No, you're not nice. You're mean. You don't kill people. That's not how we do it. All right, let's get our stuff back. And where the crap? Where are you going? What the crap? No. All right, let's get this stuff back and continue the search for stuff and things. More pearls. BRBs. Come here, man. Yeah, we're back safe and sound. At the base, but I gotta show you guys this. Check out how many pearls we got. And then if we turn this bad boy on, look at this. Watch how much composite we're gonna be able to make. There's one. 100, 200, 300, 400, 489, baby. Nailed it, Ace. It can't be stopped. That little tiny run, we got 489 of the electronics. I'm just gonna make them all. I don't even care, man. I don't know. We can always get more silica pearls. We have lots of metal. So let's just go ahead and do it now. For the polymer, we're going to need obsidian and cementing paste. And you saw we brought some of that stuff back. So let me see here. Where the heck? And okay, then. And we're back. That actually wasn't a crash or anything. It was just like a tremendous lockup. So we grabbed some of the obsidian. I can't even remember where I scored it at all now. I brought some back with me. Did I leave it on the guys? Did I squirt it all in there? Where is that stuff? Let's see here real quick. Did I leave it on poundage and tonnage? I don't think so. Oh, you gave me an egg. You're so amazing. Give it to me. I love you. All right. So, no, nothing on there. Tonnage? Nothing on there. You got 42. Why only 42? I'm so lost as to what's going on in my game right now. So, we got these guys over here like so. I brought down some obsidian. Did I squirt it all inside of the fabricator? Not there. Not there. That's oil. Did you get stuck on here? We've lost the obsidian we brought down. All right, let me find it. And we're back. I forgot I had put it all on slow mobility. It's just in his inventory. So, but up here, let's go ahead and check this out. I want to see kind of how many we're going to be able to make of the polymer as well. So each polymer takes 2 obsidian and 2 cementing paste. So how much obsidian do we bring down with us in that one little run? 1, 2, 3, 4. 466. So near to 500. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 500. Nailed it. Cementing paste. And then we'll go ahead and grab. We should probably just stand right here, right? Yeah. And then we'll just pull all this obsidian out as well. I said all this obsidian out as well. All right, there we go. We got it. Nailed the ace to give you stuff. We'll squirt this inside of here like a soap. Composite polymer, 100, 233 of that. Oh, baby, we're going to be able to build all the stuff and things. And we are back, and I've got 490 electronics and 248 polymer. And that means, check it out, peeps, look how many of the elevator pieces we can build. Wait, none? Well, we just need more metal for these. Wait, how many of these can we build? What do we need for this? 140 metal, we got some of that. Electronics, 20, we got some of that. Cementing base, 25. We've got some. I mean, we got some cementing base. Polymers, 35. 35 per, 35 apiece. We have two, what's 248 divided by 35? 7? We can only make 7? We can only make 7? That's my crotch. We can only make 7? We did all that work and we can only make 7? Look at all this space we have. Look at what could possibly be here. This base is going to be epic. But I tell you guys, I had a good time hanging out, doing stuff and things, gathering up some stuff. But we have a lot of work left to do. 248 polymer only makes you 7. And that's only the what are these even called? The elevator tracks. That's only the tracks. That's not even this. And I want to put, like, multiple elevators. It's getting a little bit dark. So Gimme! We'll turn the lights up a little bit, but yeah, so that's all the time I have for today, peeps. I had a good time hanging out. We had a good adventure. We got some stuff and things done. Off camera, I'm going to be doing a lot of gathering and the stuff and things, guys. I think we're going to set up a cementing paste station. Yeah, we have some work to do yet, but it's going to be so much fun. I can't wait. I'm really going to work on, and I really want to make sure that you guys know that off camera, I'm going to start getting a lot of this stuff done. Spend a couple hours at least, minimum, probably every night, so that we can get some really cool stuff built. But yeah, for now, that's going to be it, peeps. I hope you guys had fun hanging out. If you liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite the videos you see fit. May the stuff and things be with you. Whoa, whoa, whoa!